Hello everyone, welcome back to my kitchen, I'm Velmor. So today is going to be the final time that I double up some recipes from Heroes Feast, which means it's the last beverage from Heroes Feast. And I'm bringing it to you with the last dish from the uncommon cuisine section. I'm bringing you a dish from the Asimar, who are the angelic counterparts to the tieflings. And it's essentially carrot cake. And the next is a drink that is said to be of heaven. So it fits well with the angelic bread that I'll be making, but it's elven in nature, so it could have probably gone there, but I overlooked it during the elven section. So here it is. This is Bytopian Shepherd Bread and Evermead. Let's get started. So the only vegetables or anything that I have to prep for this is to grate the carrots. Now I'm going to mix together the dry ingredients, starting with flour, baking powder, baking soda, ginger, cinnamon, some fresh ground nutmeg, and some salt. And I'm going to whisk everything together. And now I'm going to put in some currants, and I'm going to give that a mix. Now for the wet ingredients, I'm going to start with eggs, with brown sugar. I'm going to whisk that together. And now I'm going to add in melted butter. Now I'll add in buttermilk and vanilla extract and mix that together. And now I'm going to add in the carrots, and I'll mix those around. Now I'm going to add the dry ingredients into the wet ingredients, and careful not to overmix it, I'm just going to stir everything until they're well combined. And now I'm just going to put it into the loaf pan. And the last thing before putting it into the oven, I am going to top it with some sliced almonds. And now this is going to go into the oven for about an hour. Now for the Evermead, I am going to start with some cinnamon sticks and some cloves. And I'm just going to let those toast for a few minutes. Now that those have gotten fragrant, I'm going to add in some water. And some pieces of crushed ginger. And I'm gonna let that come to a simmer. Now that this is just about simmering, I'm gonna add in some blackberry jam and some honey. I'm gonna whisk that together until everything dissolves. Then I am going to let it simmer for about 20 minutes. Then I'm gonna cover it and let it sit off the heat for another 20 minutes before it's ready to serve. Like I said, the Asimar are the angelic counterpart to the tieflings. Whereas a tiefling is somebody who may have had devilish heritage somewhere in their descendants, the Asimar has angelic heritage somewhere in their ascendants. And like the tiefling, these hereditary traits can skip generations and show up in mysterious ways. The recipe is also named after Bytopia, one of D&D's upper planes. And the upper planes are generally places where the gods find their home, settling down in lands that share their disposition. Bytopia's geography consists of two layers that look to be hanging over each other. So if you're standing on one layer, you can look up and see the other layer. And the lands are about 5-10 miles apart, so you're not really going to be able to easily communicate with somebody standing opposite of you. But you can look up and see the trees and the mountains and, you know, maybe some of the larger areas. I have spoken before about Evermead in my recipe for Moonshae seafood rice, so I'm not going to go into great detail here. It was a piece of elven heaven summoned to the planet of Toril, and it is a sacred place to the elves of the land. So both of these came out very good. The Evermead is very delicious, but honestly, it tastes a lot like a mulled wine without the alcohol. The warm spices are incredibly prevalent, and the blackberry and the honey make just a little bit of sweetness. The book does suggest that if you do want to add alcohol to it, you can use brandy. And maybe I'll do that for the next cup. And the shepherd bread was wonderful too. The carrots and currant are noticeable, but not overbearing. It has a slight sweetness, and as I suspected, this does have a consistency more of like a cake than a bread. I did have a thought when I started this to toast the almonds before I put them on the bread, but I'm glad I didn't because they got plenty toasted in the oven. And as with all the other breads I've made from the cookbook, I'm looking forward to French toast tomorrow for breakfast. I hope you guys enjoyed. You can follow me on Instagram or Twitter at chef_Velmore. The links are in the description below. Thanks for watching. Like, subscribe, and come on back next week for another recipe.